Hello friends, welcome to SQL training session. Today we will learn what is exception handling in SQL Server. Exception handling means to handle the exception. Exception is nothing but an error occurred while you are executing your T-SQL statement in SQL Server platform. So how we can handle the errors if we got any error while executing T-SQL statement? So we can handle those errors using the try catch block. So all you need to do as in .NET or as in any programming models, we always kept our code in try block so that if any of the error will come, it will go to the catch block so that we can handle those error. Similarly in SQL Server as well, we use the try catch block. So the syntax is very easy. Syntax of try catch block like this. Begin try and try. Then we need to begin catch block. So all you need to do is you need to place your code, SQL queries or code you can say, in your try catch block. And here the code to handle errors or exceptions. Only error occurred. Obviously, if error occurred, then the catch block code will be executed. Otherwise, it will not be executed. So let me give you an example here. I'll try to execute very simple statement, select 1 by 0. Here you can see I try to execute this statement and SQL Server will give me an error like divide by 0 error occurred. So this is arithmetic error and this error will be thrown by the SQL Server. So what will happen? Similarly, if I place this code in try catch block, so what will happen? The controller will go to the catch block. Instead of throwing this error right away, it will throw the complete error in the catch block, and in catch block will handle this error using the system functions, which system functions what SQL Server has provided to us. So we have list of the system function, error system functions, error functions we can say. With the help of these functions we can log our errors, we can find the many information like who run this query, at what time error occurred, and where I can log this table, in which procedure this error occurred, at what line the error occurred. So all this type of the useful information we can fetch from this system functions, from this error function. So very first is error number. So this will give you the number of error. It's an internal number which is provided by the SQL Server to each of the error. And we have error line. Will give us the line number where the SQL Server error throw an error, SQL Server engine throw an error. Then we have error message. Mostly we have a work with the message. We want to know what actually the error is, what actually error is saying. So that information is captured by the error message function, system function. Then we have error procedure also. In this example, procedure is not there. I am executing a simple statement, but just in case if it is a procedure, then it will, this error procedure function will capture the procedure name. We have error state. Error state will show you that this type of the error which was under which stage or which state. So we have a number of state, or we can say number of category of error. Some state says that this is the error which is occurred due to the user unawareness or user lack of knowledge and some of the error says, the state of error says that this is a system error. Okay, this is the there is a versioning error. So this type of the errors is categorized in state of the errors. So the system state will provide us that information. So what we'll do, we'll place our code, this code, in try block, and I'll want to know which error line this error is occurred. Let me give a name of this. I wanted to log the error message also. Let's say we want to know the message of the error. We want to know the error number, suppose. Suppose we also want to know the state of procedure name. As we do not have a procedure, so we do not need to know this. And suppose I wanted to know the state of error as well. In that case, we choose the error state function. All is done now. Now we need to execute our entire code. See here, the error is not thrown. The SQL Server has not thrown an error. Instead, the controller is moved to the cache block, and in cache block, the error is nicely captured by this system functions error line. It shows the number is 3. That means it is giving us the information that the error has occurred in the number 3. 1, 2, 3. That means error occurred in this line. Okay. Then we have a second column says message divided by 0 error occurred. So it is giving us information that you have wrongly typed and you have divided a value with a 0, which is the wrong one. That's why we are getting a divide by 0 error. Then there is an error number. This is an internal number which is provided by the SQL Server to each of the error. Then there is an error state. The state of this error is 1. So we can log the error in this way. Second thing, this is one part where you can handle the error. Another thing is, if you want to log all this information in some table, so you can do that also. So I have created one table. I have one table DB error logs in our database. So what we can do, whenever error occurred, I wanted to insert a record inside this table. So what we can do, DB. By this way, what you can do, you can log your errors inside a table so that in future you can check, okay, this is the errors. This error has happened on this particular time in this table in this line. So you can get this type of the information in this. Let me take the insert script here. Let me take the insert script quickly. Paste it in catch block here, and all I need to do is, you can see in this table I have username, error number, error state, error severity, so this type of the information, because I wanted to know which user has executed this code. So in this error, let me clean this. Username, we can say, let me give some username here, text, and then we have error number. So what you need to do, you can provide your system function, then error state. For error state, you can provide the system function error state here. Let me clean this code. This time we are logging the error in our table. Error severity. Error line number. Error message. I want to also log at what time this error has occurred. Okay, so now error will be logged. Now let us go again and execute this query, and we'll say there is no error has been thrown, and it is saying one row affected. That means one row is been inserted into DB error log. If I wanted to check what record is inserted inside DB error log, so we can do it using select extract from, and we'll check what record is inserted. Error ID is 1, username is test, error number. The error what we are seeing earlier, the same error is logged in our table, and the error date time. So it is giving me, okay, this time the error has been occurred in SQL Server database, and is and at the same time the error has been logged in the table DB error logs. So in this way you can log your error and you can handle your code and you can prevent your code to break down in SQL Server using try catch block. I hope you like the video. Thank you so much.